Dextor plays GemCraft, Frostborn Wrath from Games in a Bottle.
Welcome back to GemCraft Frostborn Wrath. We are in the next episode to go through my endurance mode. So last episode, we went screaming through journeyman mode all the way through here. Now we're going to come back and do endurance mode. And reason for this, one is just to test ourselves. Endurance mode is really about just how long can you last. You're expected to die. And if you don't die, it'll add 5 more waves the next time you play it. For the entire map, not just the one field. So in this case, we want to go in there. In addition to that, in endurance mode, we have a wizard stash here on W3. And so we're going to want to go grab that wizard stash. And so prioritizing in the endurance mode, if you've got a stash, go for the stash, even if it means you die. Get it. Because it'll have something for you. It could be something as simple as a few shadow cores, which is fine. Or it might have a skill book, which is also quite nice. So this is just letting us know that if we want to, we can drop gems into our mana pool here, and it will give us back mana. In fact, if you look at the mana pool, let's talk about the mana pool for a minute. The mana pool level 1 just says, look, if I collect 1,152 mana, if I hit that point, I'll go into mana level 2, mana pool level 2. It doesn't take away the mana. I don't have to pay for it. I only have to achieve it. And once I've achieved it, all these other things start to change. So you can see that my mana replenishes at 66 points per minute, 66 mana a minute. So I just, over time, I gain mana. If I go to level 2, it'll be faster. I don't know what it is. We'll take a look at it when that happens. I also get a mana pool XP gain multiplier. So when I kill a monster, I get mana. This is going to multiply what I get by that number. So right now it's being multiplied by 1, so whatever it gives me, I get. The mana stream skill mana gain multiplier. Oh my god, where are we going now? So there's, you have in your skill set the mana stream skill. And this is saying that whatever that skill says you get, you'll get 1.2 times that. And so you can get more and more on top of the mana stream. You can also get bonuses to your potential, your XP gain for talismans, the mana you get from orbs, also this mana pool, mana gain multiplier. So, I mean, as you go through, all these things will start to increase, and it's important. Mana pool gem damage multiplier also is one that will add damage to your mana gems in here. So just keep in mind that there are times where you want to let your mana growth sit. You don't want to spend it until you go over. Here's our wizard stash. It's just got some hit points. So I'm going to put one thing right here. I think I can get a 2. I'll put that right there. You're within range. Yes, you are. And I'm going to go ahead and throw a second one like down in here. I think that's close enough, but even if it isn't, I'm going to wait until I get up to a level 2. So here we're getting the shield being knocked on. Here's level 2. Yes, there we go. So both these guys are going to be hammering on the stash. Remember I said early, go for the stash. Go for the stash. Boom, done. I got a talisman. All right, that's fine. I didn't get everybody. And I saved. So because of that orblet, I saved, well, how much? 29 mana. Go ahead, keep going. You are going to have a hard time in the earlier parts of this, so just expect it. I could upgrade, I think, right? Yeah, let's go ahead and do it. I don't know if it'll happen quick enough. There it goes. It did happen quick enough. And we'll get it over here. And you notice I didn't do the upgrade even though I could have because I needed the mana. I think I can do it now though. So this guy has now saved me 3 times on mana loss. Now if I wanted to, I could probably do this. That's pretty funny. Oh, he got away from my orb. Give me my orb, man. I can bomb him, but it'll slowly come back and it'll get stolen. I'm pretty close to the end anyway. All right, so here's another thing. So if I speed, oh, there's the mark. See this one here? This is 14 marked reavers. So they have an extra shield. So that means I have to hit them once before I can even do damage to them. So here's a case where having traps or something out that do a lot of damage quickly, you just want to keep hitting things that are shielded, right? And then let's see, there's no giants. So now that I know that I'm about to get run over down here, you can click on this one to make them come early. You can also click way down here to make all of them come early. There's everybody. Whee! Actually, I'm surprised that you guys pushed so hard. And boom. All right. So that was the endurance mode. I made it through 14. I got a talisman, which is fine by me. I also got some experience, which, bing, gave me a level, some stuff to spend. Let's see where I can put this one. Boom, right there. What do you give me? Mana for starting waves early and initial mana if I upgrade you all the way. I'll take it. Okay, I got all the way up to the max for a 4. I'm going to get 85 mana off of this. I'm also getting extra mana starting waves early. Of course, there's some building damage, which, you know, fine, especially since I'm doing stashes right now. All right, let's do the next one here. We're going to go ahead and do this one in endurance. Wait, let me take a quick peek. Yep, there's a wizard stash. Let's see what we get. I have 93 unspent skill points. I may want to consider going back in and bumping that. But typically, if I can get to about a level 3-ish at this stage, I'd be happy. Selecting creatures and buildings, you can click on them and it'll give you some priority. So basically what it's saying is if I do this, anything within the range of shooting that will shoot this first over everything else. Okay. So look, I've got my typical, let's see, I could do a 3. Do you have a shield? No, you don't have a shield. So I can let this go for a bit. Or I could do traps. All right, let's do traps. If you do a trap, let's put this guy in here. Didn't quite get him. Am I going to get high enough? Probably not. Let's do this. And I will continue to go random. Will you bleed him out? Will you bleed him out? Yep, you will. All right, good. Traps. So this guy is going to do 54 points of damage over time. There. Where this is only going to do 8 points over time. So the traps are by far much more valuable. And some people will look at this, for example, go here and say, well, why don't you put a wall over here? I'm not going to put a wall over here. And the reason is these guys are taking the shortest path. They're not looking at this going, oh, there's a trap there. I'm going to go around it, which would make sense for smart guys to do, go around it. They are not going to do it. They're worthless that way, man. He's trying to get away. I can't let that happen. Hey, don't do that. There we go. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and drop another trap right in here. And again, my whole intent here is just to string this thing out. Can I get this in? No, I won't be able to get that in quick enough, but I can get it over here. You can actually jump your gems around. It works just fine. See, like I got this one here. I'm going to keep down here. Actually, what I'll do is I'll put them in the trap here. Am I at level 2? I am at level 2. I'm probably not going to make it to level 3 anytime real soon. Let's swap this thing out. And I'll join the other one over here. There, level 2. All right, let's speed this up a little bit. I'm going to need to put up a tower over here shortly here. Maybe I'll just do it there. And I'll put a level 2 gem up there. There it is. I want to make sure these are all set to random. Nice. Did you get out of that? Dude, I'm impressed. Okay, this is getting kind of dicey over here. All Am I going to be okay? Pause for a second here. I've got 40. No, I'm not going to be okay. Good to know. Now I'm going to be okay, right? Yes. Okay. So I wanted to put in another poison here. I'm going to do this. You can go over here. And I'll put a last one here. Come on, Wizard Stash. Nice. I got a couple of fragments. Fine. Oh, damn it. I missed my drop. Oh, it should be fine. He's poisoned. All right. Excellent. So now we're at the upgrading stage. And this, remember, the traps are going to ignore armor. Wow, this dude, he was really cranking there for a while. I got three talismen. Sweet! Alright. So we're at 1,000, right? Yeah, we're at 1,000 for the next one. Come on, give me 1160. All right, I'm going to do this one here. Well, actually, yeah, right there. Now, if you ever really worried about it, you can go ahead and do this to force them into moving. See, with that. Now I have absolute certainty that I don't have to worry about it. And you notice, again, that is pretty big. The fact that this orb keeps getting stolen and saving me some mana. Oh my god, I think I beat the wave. I beat the wave. Nice. So here we'll see, because I beat it, one, I've got this find two talismans, I get a bonus skill point. Found three talismans, I got a bonus skill point. I beat 30 waves in the endurance mode, I get a skill point. I reached 500 kills through poison. I get a skill point. Because I beat endurance mode, if they're adding 5 more waves to all endurance runs across the map. And then 1, 2, 3 things, and then talismans and some shadow cores. Very effective. Very effective for me. So the stash had a talisman in it. Nothing else really. What is this here? Giants. Damage to giants. Really? Swarmlings is starting waves early. Initial mana. I like initial mana better. Right? I can upgrade. Get some more initial mana and some additional XP. That looks good to me. I wonder. We'll go ahead and give that some points. Some Shadow Core. Got my talismans. Let's take a look at skills now. I'm up at the point where I could probably spend some, but not enough, really. Here's the mana stream one we talked about earlier on the mana pool. Okay. So let's see. What do we have here? Yep, we got another thing in endurance mode. Let's go ahead and see if we can grab this one. 104 gives me 728 mana. I think I need 900 and something to get level 3. So I still want a few more skill points here. Enraging waves. Yeah, we haven't done that yet. So what is this? Have 5 fragments socketed. Did that. Have at least 5 different talismans. Oh, nice. Okay, got that. So what this means is that if I put a gem up in here, everything after the first wave will be enraged and it'll have a bonus. So that is something to keep an eye out for. I can get a level 3 poison gem. Boom. Gonna do that. I can get a level 2 poison gem. Boom. Gonna do that. So I'm a happy camper. I'm going to go ahead and click on this because it's going to happen anyway, but by clicking on it, it does technically happen early. It's as if I called it early. So it's definitely worthwhile to do that. Here's the wizard stash. It's got a shield on it. Well, that's unfortunate. I'm going to be using a gem. Oh, darn it. I didn't do that. All right, it's fine. I'm going to go here. I'm going to say shoot at the structure, and it's going to just start poking away at the structure. All good by me. I'm going to keep going with some of these. I want to go random again. Oh, random. Are you both poisoned? You are both poisoned, but I don't know if you're actually going to bite dust. What you got left on you? 5 hit points, 5 health. Oh my god. 7 hit... Yeah, you're going to die barely. Nice. Not yet. Not yet. Come on, come on. Give me level 2. Give me level 2. Give me level 2. I'm on level 2. Damn it. There it is. But I missed this guy. Where are you at? 3 hit point... Ah! He's going to live by 1. I don't like that. Oh, he died. Okay, good. All right, whatever. I'll take it. And I have room for probably one more poison here, which I will put in. I did set that to random, didn't I? I think I did. There's level 2. Random again. How you doing over here? He's almost got the shield down, so I think I'll probably be fine. I could probably just ignore that for now. Hey! Oh, that was a level 1 gem? What the hell? Now, notice that what I can do is if I upgrade this, it's going to actually... No, that's indestructible. It's gonna hammer that? Yeah, it is. Alright, let's do... Nearest Orb. I could probably put a tower down there. I'm going to set this to least hit points. And his intent, of course, is to go ahead and pick out all the guys that are coming through that are low on health. Alrighty. I'm going to be using my next to get the bonus. It is a little bit faster, but I'm going to wait until the things are really close and then end to do the upgrade. Alright, so that's everybody. I think, there we go. Let's keep it going, people. I think it's coming across quite nicely. So I got everything I wanted off this map. Now we're just going to see how long we can survive. And this thing is going to go up. Dinger, it is level 4. Level 4 poison. It's getting there. Oh, there we go. I was being too aggressive on my upgrade. But that's fine. Like I said, I got what I needed. So we've got the first two gearing up because I had 5 fragments socketed. I have at least 5 different talisman type properties going. I've got the necrophotic, which is basically reached 1,000 points. I'm poison bananas. I go poison bananas. And then I got 2 fragments and shadow cores. Certainly worthwhile. Let's take a look at my talismans. Made another level. That's great. Do I want... What is this here? Initial mana. Trying to see if I can rearrange this somehow. Let's see if I can do that. If I swap these two... I can't put this one in. What if I take this out, put this one in... There's 3 different types. I don't see the bonus. I still want the initial mana, though. Starting waves early. Can I put that into my stash? Nope. This one could go in there. Damage of buildings. This one's better, I think. There we go. So I get some additional mana for early starts and then damage to the one guys. Now, like I said, I thought these gave me a bonus. Where's my summation? I don't see it. I heard about it. Don't see it. All right. I might have to come back and play with that some more. Buildings, initial mana. So I would like to put that one in there if I can. That's initial mana. This is initial mana. 58, 85, 79. So let's swap these two out. There we go. So what's my bonus to initial mana? 220, okay. Plus skills and stuff. Next endurance mode, let's go here. Got another chest in this one too. So we will take a look at it, see where it's at, and we'll come back for that one. So again, in the beginning, I'm really just focusing on initial mana, mostly. When I get more unspent skill points that I get to utilize, then I can deal with that differently. Targeting priorities. Okay, thank you. Reach level 20. Great. So here's my abandoned building. Here is my chest. And here's that small chest down there that I want to get at some point. I don't have anything already started, so I don't have to worry about grabbing mana for my first thing. I do have a possibility here. So I'm going to go ahead and drop an armor tearing gem. Can I do two level two? Oh, I can do a level three, huh? All right, let's do a level three slow. How close am I to level two? I'm pretty close. I'm going to let that go. I'm going to wait till I get a level two. So now I want to put another gem over here. Now these things probably are armored. It is. So I'm going to want to get my level... Oh, man. Really? Can I go... Ah, damn it. I had level 2 there. I think I did. There it is. Go for structures. So this guy is going to be tearing away the armor, which makes it more effective at killing it. This will take a level 2 to pop that. I think maybe if I do this. Nice. Okay, so we opened it up. I didn't even see. I was paying attention elsewhere. highest shielded. I got the highest shielded, right? I think I did. What are you coming in with, armor-wise? No armor there, so it's been stripped off whatever it is. You're coming in with 14 points of armor. I'm stripping 15, so I'm still fine with that. I could put these two together. Do I want to? I am going to have to bomb this later, so I think I might save it. Let us throw this guy here. I will continue to shoot the highest one. It'll do damage to somebody, but hey. And it's going to take a couple of shots at the static beacon. While it's there, why not? I could do an upgrade, but I'm going to upgrade this one back here. Because I want to join the blues. Wait for a break. There. Alright, we'll let that go. I've got my stash. I only want to bomb the building before we're done, so we'll just let this run for a minute. Well, hello. Look at you guys. You should go least. Ah! Damn it. I missed my bombing. I didn't realize I could get run over. So I got mana salvation. Salvage mana by destroying a gem. Yep, did that. Good. And I got haste battle trait. So I did get something out of this. That's good. So what is the haste battle trait? We'll see that in this next one. We're going to go here. This also has a wizard stash. So let's see if we can get out of that. Here's where it says battle traits. Okay. So battle traits are all of these spots in here. Each one of these is a trait that we will discover at some point in time. This trait here is haste, which says the 8% faster wave starts, or stones. I don't think it says means stones, is it? Yeah. Each stone that comes up is going to be, the critters in there are going to be 8% faster, and you can go all the way up to, I think, 12. Yeah, max level is 12, so I can double the speed if I want to. It increases the multipliers up at the top here. You can see the battle traits and the drop rate for talismans. This is the rarity level, so it'll drop between level 3 and level 26. But when I bring it down to here, it's 1 to 20. Okay. You can also do this. You can click to grant plus 10 rarity by dropping 100 shadow cores. This is not a permanent change. This is a one time. This for this run, for 100 shadow cores, you can increase the rarity by 10. Don't do it. Just don't do it for now. Wait until you're way in the, you know, you've got shadow cores coming out of your backside. Then maybe you can do that, but don't do it now. Okay? Endurance mode. Here we are. We're on. Well, damn it. Am I on the right field? Yes. S3. Endurance. Start. We'll see if we make this one or not. Again, we're going to go for the stash. Later on, we might come back through the endurance modes for experience. But at this point, we're just trying to get all the stashes. Here's the stash down here. We've seen this one. You'll notice the field changed a little bit. There's a force thing where it comes right through here. Again, I want to try to get a max gem. Bing, bam, boom. I will put another one here. I get a 2. Yep, let's do that. You go for that. What's your level? 2. Okay. So he's got a shield that he's going to be knocking out. That's fine. Okay, I can get a level 2 blue, which I will put out in front of this one. And I don't care about that. I'll use that to bomb something later. How are we doing down here? Perfect! Shadow cores. I've got a whole pile of shadow cores. That's great. 580 is probably what I'm waiting for. Just in time for everything else to come through, of course. Let's go for least again. I like that for the trailing gem. Okay, so I can do a join. Yeah, I can. Let's go ahead and join these two level 3s. Get a level 4 going. We're going to milk this thing for a little bit. I already got my stash. I'm fine. We're done for all intents and purposes. I could come up here and play with this. But it does have armor on it. Do I want to? I'm going to wait till I get to a level 3 gem. And maybe I will play with it a little bit. Let's see what happens. Here's level 3. Alright. You know what? Let's just do that for fun. Structures. Oh, you're getting through. Oh, no. Do I care? What if I drop you? Just for the fun of it. Can I get this down? It would be nice to get the monster nest down. It's close. It's going to be close. Got it. Fire in the hole. Yep. Least. What was that noise? Something. Ah. All right. Well, we made it. All the way up. And I got another skill point because I took out a monster nest. Just for the fun of it. All right. So we've got Shadow Cores as our payout there. There is no stash here. I think I'm going to stop at that point with our progress so far. Let's go ahead and take a look at Talismans. I've got some Shadow Cores I could spend if I want to. Starting waves, early swarms. Could get initial mana here. What's your level? 10? Will you go into... Yes, you will. All right, let's do that then. Pop! Initial mana. I don't have enough, huh? You're already maxed. Swarmlings I really don't care too much about. You're already maxed. So I want 35 Shadow Cores. Yeah, I need 35 Shadow Cores to upgrade. Will any of these go into my shapes? Yes. So I'm just collecting shapes as I can go. I prefer, honestly, just to keep, especially in the beginning, throw the shapes into my shape collector so I can swap shapes around later. It just feels a little bit better for me. This, if you hover over it, we'll show you the level, you know, the rarity. It's the first thing on each of these things. If you look right in the center here, you'll see it says 4/0/2. It tells me what's upgraded, what's not. So I can see that I could upgrade the centerpiece, but it's only a level 4, so I'm not even going to bother. I'll probably toss that into the mix when it comes time. In fact, can I? Yes. It's that piece right there. It's unhighlighted, so I could use that. Anyway, there we go. Let's take a look, quick peek at skills. 138 gives me... That's enough for level 3, so I'm happy with that. If anything, I could always just pop a couple there. One there, that's fine. Gives me a little bit more trap damage, because I do like my traps. But when we come back, we will continue to go on with the journeyman mode through here. We'll see how far we can get in journeyman mode on the next one, and then we'll come back and do some endurance again. All right? So thanks again for joining me. Take care. Bye-bye.
Creeping through the shadows in the corners of your mind. I go where the wind blows. I run but I don't hide. I hear the call of the wild, whispering my name. No, I can't be tamed. My heart belongs to the night. I'm alone, I'm alone, I'm a lone wolf. 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 I'm a